here in Paris because the French translation of my last novel, The Snow Queen, has just come out. The Snow Queen is the story of two brothers, one of whom is just a regular secular citizen who doesn't believe in God, has no religion, but sees a vision in the sky one night. What do you do if you have no belief and you see a celestial body revealed to you? What do you do about that? And his brother is an aspiring musician, but no longer young, no longer so hopeful of a big career. And while Barrett, the younger brother, has had a vision he doesn't want, Tyler, the older brother, desperately writing new songs, is looking for a vision that won't come. So we have two men, one of whom God has chosen to point the finger at, who says, no, 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 not me. The other of whom is saying, please, God, point the finger at me, make me a great artist. And it is really the story of what happens to these two men. You know, I always start a novel with the characters. A novel is, to me, more than anything about its people. And I've found that if you imagine characters sufficiently, if you know them well enough, if you know what they want, if you know what they fear, if you know them as well as you possibly can, they always make a story happen. We make stories happen just by living our lives. It's a book about religion and drugs and faith and art and shopping. Shopping is its lesser theme. I actually do not think that shopping ranks with hope and transcendence. But it's a book in which a great deal happens in a very short span, and I hope that it's about transcendence. I mean, I know that's a little pretentious to say, but I hope that it's about our human ability to survive our lives, our very difficult lives. Well, you know, it's funny about having lived long enough to write several novels. You realize as they start to pile, well, my pile isn't that, you know, they sort of pile up like this. There are common themes. I seem to write about families, about bonds between brothers. I write about people who are in terrible turmoil. And who somehow always persevere. All my novels have happy endings, though I only believe in a happy ending that can survive the worst that can happen to people. It's almost as if you spend your life writing novels in order to learn what matters most to you, and you only find out as the novels begin to accumulate. The title, The Snow Queen, came to me very early, and it is also the title of a fairy tale by Hans Christian Andersen. The book is very loosely based on the Hans Christian Andersen fairy tale. It's not really a sort of postmodern rethinking of a fairy tale. I just love the title so much. And I thought, well, Hans Christian Andersen doesn't just get this title forever. I can use it as well. My French publisher, Belfond, in their great wisdom, have published this novel with its American title, English title, Snow Queen. To sort of dispel too many associations with the fairy tale. And I agree with them entirely. I wish my American publisher had the good sense to title the American edition in French.